I think he made 8 or 9 straight stops at the end of the game. He had a pretty good team. So it comes in different packages. I think that's who we are. Our team is, you know, it's got 9 or 10 guys that can help us at certain moments. And hopefully we're coming together and connecting and having a little more confidence along the way.
Well, being on the road,
Road is always a little more difficult. It takes a little more mental toughness, takes a little more focus, takes a little more discipline, takes a little better habits. I think that's it's going to be a partial test. You know, our schedule has not been very nice to us. I think 9 of our next 11 are on the road, so that's not good. No one's going to feel sorry for us. We're just going to go out and get better and learn, and hopefully steal some wins and build some confidence by winning on the road, because once you do win on the road, it doesn't grow faster. There's an extra. Not only is it more difficult, but it has a little more magnification of your power.
When they pull an outboard for now, stretch on the floor and shooting for getting more space. Defending that, has that become a system thing, or do you have to have the right personnel that you have to find that can get out there? Or?
You know, it's reads. It's very difficult, but, you know, you got big guys who've been taught the habit is to protect the basket. And so when a ball is driven at a big guy, it's just an instinct, say, protect the basket. And they're basically just trying to trick him into giving up a wide open three. There are ways that you can cover the pick and roll, but everything has weaknesses and counters. And so I think, you know, we're the pulse of the game, read the game, how I go. Is that shot going to be this? Is that shot, you know, some nights it's going to beat you, some nights you might be able to get away with giving it up.
On the flip side, are you getting more comfortable with DeMarcus taking those outside shots?
Well, we were pretty much all training camp and at least experimenting with it, and I think he's shown that he likes it. Right now, you know, he's, and as you know, you all have been talking about, it's easier to get a big guy in open three than sometimes getting Mark Bellinelli in open three. So the game allows that because of the habits of the game a little bit. And a couple of those wins we had because of making those 2 or 3 threes in a row were very big momentum pushers, builders for us.
George, have any thoughts on that, Kevin McHale?
Yeah, sad. It's disappointing and sad. I better keep my mouth shut. I could probably philosophize to the wrong side of the fence on that one.
You talk about your profession as a whole.
I'll save that for my book.
What's it called now? What's the title?
Stuff I couldn't say. I mean, we all are in a situation where we're blessed to have a job. And it's a, you know, when you have 1 of 30, it's something that is humbling a lot. But it's a difficult job. Whatever you want, you know, the pieces that have come into the game over the last 20, 30 years, maybe 15, 20 years, have made it more difficult for being to be an head coach. No, I enjoy it, but there seems to be consistently, almost on a daily basis, something that gets crazier and wilder and more interesting. And, you know, from the internet impact of what the internet and blogs and talk radio and big contracts, multi-million dollar players. I mean, there's all types of things that the head coach is on his plate. And he has to handle not only success, but he also has to handle failure. He has to handle young players, old players, veteran players, agents. I mean, there's all types of things on that plate.
So it's not all about winning?
Well, I used to be winning kept you, you know, if you want, you usually kept your job. Last 10 years, that's not been the case.
Your bud has dual roles, coach and general manager. That's something that maybe coaches need. All coaches need like some sort of position title.
I personally think history tells us that works more efficient than maybe some of the other systems that people try. We had Pop and Raleigh and, you know, Jerry Sloan, and, you know, he wouldn't have a title, but, you know, they did everything that Jerry Sloan wanted to do. It just, you know, it seems like, you know, when the head coach has a big impact on the organization, there seems to be a lot more success.